Good afternoon, YouTubers, and thanks again for checking in for the videos here. Today we're going to reintroduce a model that I gave a demonstration of earlier in my career. But the reason I'm redoing this is because at that time I didn't have the proper 33 spindle. So we're going to do the demonstration in its entirety here, both with 33 and 45. To introduce the player, this is introduced in 1949 and continued through 1950. It's called an Admiral number 5W1, and it had a very unusual changer inside. The changer was called an RC400, unique, and I believe only to this player. I don't know of any other player that they put this in. This is a 33-45 player. You'll notice that over here is the selector for 33 and 45. The reject button. Of course, there's your tone arm and the kick for the 33. And incidentally, these are 7-inch 33s and 7-inch 45s. And notice the turntable. It's unusual. You have a hole in the center, and then you have the three horizontal holes there. And there's a reason for that, which I'll get into in a minute. The first thing to look for when buying these players are the pitfalls. This is the third one I've owned. The first two I had had problems, so I'm going to tell you the problems to look for. These are scarce. Believe me when I tell you, this is in the same class as the Zenith Twin Seven. The Twin Seven had two turntables in it, a 33 and a 45 table. These are a totally different system. And this model never really caught on because what happened is the spindles were the first thing to get lost. I'm going to show you those in a minute. But you'll notice that the hinges here, they're small. And there are stops on it so that when this is pushed back, it stops. And quite often what happens is what happened in the first two players, the hinges break or the Bakelite itself breaks because of too much pressure pulling this back. This one is correct the way that it should be. The second thing to look at is the case. These cases are Bakelite. They're probably some of the worst Bakelite I've ever seen. For whatever reason, Admiral didn't get their crap together here. When they made the Bakelite. It's kind of a very inexpensive Bakelite, or not very well made Bakelite. Not as good as the RCAs were made in the past. This one happens to be in superb shape, put a pretty good shine on it, but some of these take a lot of work to get the shine. At the face, we have the dial, of course, here, the AM radio dial. Over here we have the on-off volume control. On this side we have the tuning control and a three-position switch for AM radio, neutral, and turning the changer on. The pitfalls again. This is the one item that always seems to be missing. This is the 33 adapter, and it was only made for this one changer, period. So it's damn near impossible to find. It was a stroke of luck that one came my way. I called Gary at VM. Not only did he not have one in stock, but he said he never had one pass through his hands. That's how scarce they are. The second thing, the pitfall here, is this right here. This is the 45 adapter. Now it's an unusual adapter. You notice this leg hanging down the bottom of it. And it's a push rod that moves the sheaves in and out to drop the 45s. Additionally, put it over here so you can see it, there are three dog legs on it. The dog legs are usually broken. You'll always find them with one or two broken legs on them because you have to be very careful with them. They're made of Bakelite. If you apply too much pressure on the damn things, whether it's the push rod that forces the whole unit up because it's incorrectly adjusted, or whether you drop it, whatever the case may be, they're just hard to find and find working correctly. We're going to demonstrate the radio first, and so we're going to put this into the AM radio side.
Listen clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are.
See? 94621, or by making.
CO Waterbury, WMMW Mary.
1380 AM WKS Dakota. So one side of town was taken away by a tornado today. The South Dakota Department of Public Safety.
All right, we're going to put this into the neutral position. And note that the AM radio, or at least the chassis in this thing, consists of a standard All-American 5 sub-miniature tube. And there's another pitfall that I forgot to tell you about, these dials. Quite often when you find them, and even this has got a little bit, these little surface cracks here. This is very typical of any of the Admirals, because on the backside of this is a spring that holds it into place. And just over a period of time, because of the pressure that's being placed on these dials, they have little surface cracks. There's nothing you can do about it. I haven't seen one yet that's perfect, not a one. So that's another pitfall to look out for. In any event, let's give you a demonstration. Looking inside again, we're going to put the 45 adapter on, remembering that we're going to drop this into place in the center. Make sure you line it up with the holes here and make a counterclockwise turn to drop it into place. We're going to put two records on here, remembering again that this is not for the content of the music, but rather to demonstrate the player. This is the Trolley Song by the High Lows. That'll be our first one here. And we're going to do Can't We Just Be Friends by the Taffies. And we're going to put this into the play position. And let's give her a reject. Enough of that. Let's go back to the neutral position. Let's remove the 45 adapter and carefully put it away so that it doesn't get broken. And now we're going to install the 33 adapter. And you'll notice there are little legs on this thing right where my right where my fingers are down here. And we're going to drop this in place. Let me make sure I get this right. And we're going to put a couple of 33s on here. We're going to do, and again, not for the content of the music, but to demonstrate the record. This would be the 7-inch 33. We're going to do Nick Lowe and Dave Edmonds sing the Everly Brothers, Take a Message to Mary. And while we're at it, let's make sure we swing this into the 33 position, like that. And we're going to do It Must Be Him by Vicky Carr. And going back to the start position. As you can see, it's moving around. And let's do the reject.
These are the words of a frontier lad who lost his life.
Take a message to Mary, but don't say I'm in love.
That it rejects properly.
I tell myself, what's done is done. I tell myself, don't be a fool. Play the field, have a lot of fun. It's easy when you play it cool. I tell myself, don't be a chump. Who cares? Let him stay away. That's when the phone rings and I jump. And as I grab the phone, I pray. Let it please be him. Oh dear God, it must be him.
Okay, and I'm just going to grab the arm here as she rejects. I tell you, it's a grand little player. It's one of my personal favorites. I love the fact that this plays the 33s and the 45s. To me, that's stupendous, because that's what makes the player, to be able to play both 7-inch 33s and 45s. Unfortunately, there are a lot of people out there that like the VM 16 45 changers that I just find to be as useless as tits on a bull. I mean, yes, it's got auto shut off, which is great. Obviously, this one doesn't. But other than that, who the hell listens to 16s? That's the only redeeming factor, in my personal opinion, for the VM 16 45 changers. This, to me, has a little more class, and we have an AM radio to boot, with a good-sized speaker, and the tone is actually pretty darn good, too. So there you have it. Something that's not often seen today, very hard to find, and now you have an idea of the pitfalls to look for when you do find one. Again, introduced in 1949, the Admiral, model number 5W1, and that has an RC400 changer in it. And it's a beautiful piece. I hope you enjoyed seeing something different. Again, an early 1950s piece. I hope you enjoyed watching it and learning a little something. Have a great day now.